गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. बीएसटी क्लास 12th चैप्टर 1. टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग रिवीजन एंड इन जस्ट वन क्लास विल बी रिवाइजिंग द कंप्लीट चैप्टर. सो दैट वी टोटल वी हैव 5 days एंड इन दिस 5 days वी हैव टू रिवाइज द ऑल 5 chapters. So that all the concepts are revised and you people are able to solve the paper on Monday. Okay, students. Yes, Shubhangi. Suprabhat. अच्छा लगा ये पढ़कर. Yes. Yes, students. So chapter 1 was all about the nature and significance of management, if you remember. Okay, so first is the in chapter 1 we did the concept of management first, means the meaning of management. So there I told you that management is the art of getting things done through and with the people in formally organized group. So management is the art of getting things done through and with the people. Why it is written that through and with the people? Through means you are taking getting work done from others, but no doubt you are also becoming the part of the work of the group. You are also the part of the group. So through and with the people in formally organized group, it means the organization is a formal organization and people are working in groups. So I told you one more thing there, that management can be done only when a group of people is working. It cannot be done in isolation. One more definition I had given you of management, that was the management is a process of 5 interrelated functions. Which functions? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Why management is done? That is the rest part of the definition. To accomplish the organizational objectives through the coordinated use of human and material resources. This is the definition of management. So both the definitions are good. Any one definition you can do. Then the next topic of the management was the characteristics or feature of management. There I told you total 7 characteristics. So management is a goal-oriented process. Management is a goal-oriented process. It means we have done the management to achieve the organizational goal. Every organization has different type of goals. And goals must be SMART. I had given you one word there, SMART. S-M-A-R-T, SMART. S for specific. M for measurable, A for achievable, R for realistic, and T for time bound. All these are the features which should be there in your objective. So every organization has set some objectives and it is striving to achieve those objectives. Second feature is dynamic process, means we have already seen that the business management has to keep working in the dynamic environment. So there are different type of changing environment which we have already studied in chapter 3, social environment, economic, political, legal and technical factors. So due to all these factors, businessman also needs to change its policies and change its decisions. Next, like McD had made major changes in menu to survive in Indian market, and there I gave you example that the Aloo Tikki Burger is included only in Indian market, not in the foreign countries market. So this is the type of the burger which is included by McD with reference to Indian environment only. It is not included in other countries environment. Okay. So next is the multidimensional process. Management is a multidimensional process. Multidimensional process means it has 3 dimensions. Management of work, management of people, then management of operations. Management, in this I told you that in every organization some work is performed, like in school teaching is done, in factories manufacturing is done. Then management of people means human resource. So management of people I told you has 2 dimensions, dealing the people as individuals, then dealing individuals as a group of people, because as individual people have some different type of needs and as individuals or group have different type of needs. Group goal and individual goal must to be satisfied. Then management of operation means combination of management of people and management of work. So it requires a production process to convert the inputs and technology into desired output. So that is the management of operation. So this is interlinked with both management of work and management of people. So whenever we are talking about of management of operations, it means every organization has to do the both aspects of management. That is the management of people and management of work. So both should be considered. Next, continuous process. Management is an ongoing process, non-stopping process. All the functions, planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling needs to be performed by all the persons. Next, management is a group activity. I told you there that management cannot be performed in isolation. So it is a group activity. Wherever a group of people is working, so their management will be required to get the work done from that group of people. Okay, students. So next is the next feature is management is intangible, and there I told you that management is an intangible force, means which cannot be seen or touched, but its presence can be felt. How? If we are seeing that in there is an organization and there is everything in order, there is no chaos, employees are happy, and there is orderliness in each and everything without any chaos, and the employees are basically happy and satisfied, they are not having any grievances, it means management is good, management is there, and that are the after effects of the good management. So we can say that the management in that particular organization is good. So in case study, the last two lines can be the case study breaker line. Employees are happy and satisfied, and there is orderliness instead of chaos. So that will be the management intangible. Yes, students, make sure, three students ko bhi maine admit kiya hai, Nishtha, Parth and Sahil. आप अगर आगे से लेट आएंगे ना, मैं क्लास स्टार्ट होने के दो मिनट के बाद किसी को भी एडमिट नहीं करूंगी. डेली आप लोगों का ऑलरेडी मैं क्लास लेट ले रही हूँ, और फिर आप 10-10, 15-15 मिनट लेट क्लास में एंटर कर रहे हैं. तो मेक श्योर कि नेक्स्ट क्लास से आप एंटर नहीं होंगे अगर आप लेट आ रहे हो. नेक्स्ट, परवेसिव. मैनेजमेंट इज परवेसिव. परवेसिव मीन्स यूनिवर्सल. इट इज फाउंड इन एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वेदर इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नेचर, साइज एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव. So these were the seven features of management. Next topic is importance of management. Management importance, I told you that three objectives of management. I told you management organizational objective, social objective and personal. And three importance points are related to those three objectives. Okay. So these three important points are related to three importance points, like organizational goal means group goal, achievement of group goal. Management helps to achieve group goal. This is the first objective. Second, increases efficiency. Yes, these two concepts are missed. Management is a process to achieve the organizational goal effectively and efficiency. Effectively means achieving the goal on time without considering cost, doing the right task on time. And efficiency means achieving the goal considering the cost. So wherever you are considering the cost only, it means you are efficient. At minimum cost you are doing work, it means you are efficient. And if you are not considering the cost, but you are considering just the completion of the goal on time, so wherever time is talked about, it means the manager is effective. Wherever cost is talked about, it means the management is efficient. So a manager should be both efficient and effective. So management increases efficiency because while doing the good management, all the resources will be properly utilized, right person will be given the right duty, there will be no wastage and overlapping of the resources. So ultimately it will be increasing the efficiency of the organization. And efficiency means producing more output with the same input, or producing same with the lesser input, means you are efficient. Creates dynamic an organization because management changes its policy, keeping in mind the changes in the environment, business environment. So management creates a dynamic organization. So that dynamic organization means not a static organization, not a rigid organization. Flexibility is there. Depending on the situation of the environment, you can change your plans and policies. Helps in achieving personal objective. Every employee in the organization has entered with his own personal goal or objective. So management creates such an environment where the employees will be able to achieve their own personal objectives. Okay. So next is the helps in development of society. It means fulfilling of the social responsibility with the help of the management. When the management is good, then they must be getting profits. And if they are getting profits, then they will be able to achieve the organizational goal, as well as now they will be able to spend more on the social welfare. So helps in development society, how management helps in development society by creating more and more job opportunities by doing the social welfare activities like giving jobs to the physically challenged people, upkeep of the parks, or adopting of a slum area and doing the beautification of that particular area and making the giving donations for the child welfare and for the widow welfare. So all such type of are the organizational objectives. Okay, students. So all these are the example of organizational objectives. Wait a minute. So next is the, so these are the five points of importance of management. Again, I am explaining the heading, achievement of group goals, increasing efficiency, creates dynamic organization, helps in achieving personal objectives, helps in development of society. So now the next slide, which is in relation to the all this explanation I have done. So objectives of management, I told you three objectives of management are there: organizational objective, social objective, and personal objective. Organizational objective, I told you three: survival, profit, and growth. So when survival means recovering the cost, it means you are selling the goods at the revenue price so that you people are able to cover the cost. So if you are able to cover the cost, it means you are able to survive. Then profit. After survival, definitely you are going to think about the profits. So profit is the reward of the risk taking of the businessman. Businessman has taken the risk. So for that, he must be getting the profits. Okay. Then third objective is growth. So when businessman has earned the good profits, then definitely he will be thinking about the growth of the business. Growth means like expansion of the business. Now earlier you were having a local shop. Now you want to open many more branches of your business. Earlier you were having the business only at the local level, district level. Now you want to enter in the state level business. And after that you want to enter the international business. Okay. So all these are the example of growth. Then second objective is social objective. You all know very well that the very social obligations, business is using the society resources. For those society resources, it has some social obligations like giving employment to the society, providing basic amenities. Third is the personal objective. Personal objective means giving salary on time to the employees. Employees are having some needs like the basic needs, security needs, financial need. We have discussed earlier all these needs. So it is the prime most objective of the organization to fulfill all the needs of the employees so that employees are ready to give their 100% for the organization. So three objectives are there: personal, social, and organizational. Then next, nature of management. I told you that management is a science, management as a profession, and management is an art. Science, what do you mean by science? Science is a systematic body of knowledge. Science is a systematic body of knowledge and which is based on general truths. General truths means some things are the truths and that are based on some systematic body of knowledge. So management is a science or not? There we discuss that management is not a complete science. It is an inexact science or impure science. So we can say management is a soft science and it is a science just like any other social sciences. Why? because management has to deal with human being, and behavior of one human being is different from other. So we cannot say the applying of the one principle on a group of people will be giving the same result when it is applied on the other group of people. Why? Because in group of people, different type of human beings are there, and they cannot say think in the same manner. So that's why it is said that some of the features of science are present in management and some of them are not present, like systematic body of knowledge. So science has a systematic body of knowledge. Knowledge is there, theories are there, principles are there. So in management also there are some principles, like science as a principle, law of gravitation. So whenever you will be applying that law, you will be having the same result in each and everything. So management is also a systematic body of knowledge, and management also has its principles, like we have studied in chapter 2. Then science principles are based on observation and experimentation, and they are formed in the laboratories after doing the many observations. So management principles are also developed over a period of time. They are not the result of overnight efforts. But since it deals with human behavior, so results are not so exact. But in science principle, whenever we will be applying science principle, every time we will be getting the same result. But in management, we will not be getting the same result. Universal validity. So the two features out of those, first was present and second is not present. Then universal validity, management principles, science principles are having universal validity. Universal validity means they will be holding true under each and every situation, like principle of gravitation. So if we are applying this principle on a chair, on a person, on an apple, then everything we will be getting the same result, and that will be holding true. So principle of management are not universal. They have to be modified according to the situation. We have studied this in that management principles are general guidelines. General guideline means they are just showing us a path. How to use that principle depends on the nature of the persons, nature of the organization, as well as on the situation. What is the situation? So we can say that principle of science are having a universal validity, but management principles are not having universal validity. So at the end, we need to conclude. So in the conclusion, we have to write that the sum of the features are present and some are not present. Only one feature is present and two main features are not present. So we cannot say that the management is a complete science. So it is a social science, soft science, or inexact science. So next is the management as an art. An art, what is the art? I told you that art is the skillful and personal application of existing knowledge to achieve desired results. Yes, personalized application of knowledge. So every artist has some knowledge, and how he is going to apply that knowledge, that is his own personal way. That's why it is said that personalized application. Like teaching is an art. If I am teaching here, then I am having some knowledge, and how I am going to apply that knowledge is, it's my own manner. It may be matched with some other person or may not be matched. Suppose there are 500 teachers of accountancy in a particular locality. So all will be having the same qualification to teach the accountancy subject. But the method, the way of their teaching will be definitely different. Why? Because that is a personalized way or manner to use the skillful knowledge. So now we have to analyze whether the management is art or not. So first is the existence of theoretical knowledge. Yes, this feature is present. Just like any art has some knowledge, so similarly, management has also some theoretical knowledge. Like if you are going to learn the music, so music is an art. So literature is also available in music. Painting, many students are doing painting as a subject. So painting does not mean only making drawings. It has its own literature. So every art has some theoretical part. So similarly, management has also its own theoretical part. Second is personalized application. Management, the artist has to use the knowledge in his own manner, in his own personal way. Two singers having the same basic knowledge of music will sing differently. Two doctors who have passed the same degree from the same college, from the same city, but the way of treating the patient will be different. So a manager is also having the MBA. Many persons are MBA, but each and every manager is handling the problems, day-to-day problems, in his own way. So we can say that the management is an art. This feature is present. Third, based on practice and creativity. Art is always based on practice and creativity. So whatever the knowledge the artist is having, that can be polished more by using it again and again and by showing its innovative and expertise skills. So one day he will become expert. How? By using, by doing the practice of that particular and by using his own creational skill, creativity. Like if a teacher has started his career at that time, he or she is a fresher in his field. So he or she may not be having the complete knowledge, because whatever he will be teaching, he will be just studying from the books and he will be giving the knowledge to the students. But whenever a teacher who is experienced for 15 years, 10 years, then definitely he will be having more knowledge, because whatever the knowledge he has got from books, apart from that, he has learned many things from his experience and he will be giving those expertise things to their students. So that's why students always enjoy to study from an experienced teacher. Why? Because the with his experience, he can use the expertise. So similarly, a management can also earn by his experience and formulates his own theories and ways for in using given situations. So next is the, so these are the three features of the art, and we can see that all these three are present. All these three are present. Okay, so we can say that the management is completely an art. Shruti, आपने भी अभी एंटर किया है, आगे से मैं क्लास में अलाउ नहीं करूंगी. मेक श्योर क्लास के बिगनिंग में एंटर करो, आगे से मैं क्लास को लॉक कर दूंगी 5 मिनट के बाद. सो मैनेजमेंट, वी कैन से दैट मैनेजमेंट इज अ कंप्लीट आर्ट, बिकॉज ऑल द फीचर्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट आर्ट आर प्रेजेंट इन मैनेजमेंट. देन मैनेजमेंट एज अ प्रोफेशन, यस मैनेजमेंट इज अ प्रोफेशन. नाउ वी मस्ट नो द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रोफेशन. सो इफ द क्वेश्चन कम्स इन एग्जाम दैट मैनेजमेंट, explain the nature of the management. So you are going to say that management as a science, management as an art, both. You have to explain both. So it will, you will explain both management as science, management as art. Okay, then afterwards in the conclusion, this question comes normally in 6 marker. What is the nature of management? So after that, you have to write a paragraph in conclusion that management is science as well as art, because science aspect of management gives us knowledge and art aspect of management tells us how to apply that knowledge. Because science gives us knowledge and art tells us how to apply that knowledge. And when we did the chapter, then I had given you one quotation that science and art aspect of management are just like two blades of a scissors. Like a blade, a scissor has two blades and both blades are required to cut the cloth. If there is only one blade, then the cloth cannot be cut perfectly, or it will not be possible to cut the cloth. So both the blades are required. So similarly, art aspect and science aspect are the two blades of a scissors, and by using both the blades, the manager can be successful only while solving the day-to-day problems. So this will be the ending. Okay, so this will be the ending of this topic. Then a complete 6 marker question comes on the topic management as profession. Okay, so management as profession means, here again you have to first define the profession. So manage profession means a well defined body of knowledge which can be acquired through training and instructions, and it follows ethical standards. For example, doctors, advocates. So we can easily define the profession. One more definition I am giving you, that profession is an occupation which requires specialized knowledge and skills. Itna bhi agar aap likh dete hai, then it is the complete definition of profession. Profession is an occupation which requires a special knowledge and skills, and that knowledge and skill can be acquired through training and instructions. So now we have to check whether the management is profession, yes or no. Then again we have to find out the features of the profession. The basic features are well-defined body of knowledge. Yes, management, all the professions are having the well-defined body of knowledge. You can see that the first point is present in all the three. When we did management as science, then I told you systematic body of knowledge. When we did management as an art, then I told you theoretical knowledge. And here, well-defined body of knowledge. So in all the three headings or topics, first part is related to the knowledge, and this first feature is present in all. So every profession has its own knowledge, own theory, and which can be required through instructions. So similarly, management has also its own knowledge. And nowadays, it has become a discipline in which you can get the bachelor's degree, like BMS, Bachelor's in Management Studies. There you are going to study only management subject. So the next is the restricted entry. In every profession, the entry of the is restricted. How? Like you want to enter in CA profession. So you have to first clear the CPT, Fundamental Examination of CA. And when you will be clearing that CPT exam, only then you are allowed to enter in CA profession. Then further exams you will be giving. So similarly, like you want to become a CS, company secretary, then again there is a foundation course. And without that foundation course, you are not allowed to enter in that field. After clearing that, again, you have to pass many exams. Only then you will be allowed to do the practice as a company secretary, CS. So restricted entry is there. But in management, no restricted entry is there. No additional qualifications are required. Sometimes the person is having good amount of money. He is the owner of the business. And he himself has become the manager of the business. So we can say that for becoming a manager, no particular degree or no particular restricted entry is not there. Then professional association. In management, in all the professions, there are some associations with which all the professions are related. They are having their attachment with the professional associations. And Ishita, you have also entered right now. Please give me your reason in chat box why you have entered after the 30 minutes of the class. Right now, otherwise I will remove you. Send me your answer. All professions are affiliated to a professional association which regulates entry, grants certificates of practice and formulates and enforces a code of conduct. So that particular professional association is conducting all the exams and they are making all the rules and regulation, and as well as they are formulating the policies and code of conduct, and they are giving the certificate to their all the candidates who are associated with that professional association. Okay, students, wait a minute. So next, there is no compulsion for managers to be the members of any management association. Hence, this criterion is not fully satisfied in management. So we can say that this feature is also not present, professional association, because managers need not to be associated with any such type of professional association. Rather, for managers, there is one association which is known as AIMA, All India Management Association. But it's not compulsory for the managers to be the part of that particular association. Then ethical code of conduct, all the professionals are required to follow the ethical code of conduct, means rules and regulations made by that particular professional association. But for managers, as there is no professional association, so how can be ethical code of conduct there? So there is no ethical code of conduct. No doubt AIMA has made its own ethical code of conduct, but it's not compulsory for the managers to follow that code of conduct. So there is no fines, no penalties if the managers are not following the code of conduct, because the membership is not required. If membership is not required, then how we can expect that the managers are following the code of conduct? Then last one is the service motive. In profession, everywhere the main motive is service. Like you can see that in doctor profession, now each and every doctor is on his or her toes. Why? Just because of service motive. In this pandemic period, each and every doctor is providing their services. So it's a service motive. But in management, we cannot have the service motive. Management is done for the business, and business we have not started for the charity. We have started business for earning the profits, because profits are required for the survival of the business, not only to fulfill the organizational objective, but also to fulfill the social responsibilities too. So we can say that this motive is also, this feature is also not present in the management. So at last we have to conclude. And what is the conclusion? Conclusion is this, that the management, out of the five features, only one feature is present in management. Out of the five features, only one feature is present in management. So management does not fulfill the exact criteria of the profession. All the features are not present. So what we can say? We can say that management is not a full-fledged profession. It is on the path of becoming a profession in near future. In near future, it will be compulsory for all the managers to have a degree like MBA in management and to be the part of the professional body, which is very much there for the managers, and to follow all the rules and regulations. In coming days, it may be possible, but now, not today. So we will be saying that management is not a full-fledged profession. So this is the main line. It cannot be recognized as a full-fledged profession. So 2-6 marker question. One is the nature of the management. If nature of the management comes in exam, then you are going to explain only art and the science aspect. And management as a profession, you have to explain the complete topic, management as a profession. The levels of management. So time left is very less. So I'm being very fast now, because level of management was a very easy topic we have done. Three levels of management are there: top level, middle level, and lower level. You can see from this diagram, top level means board of directors, chairman, president, and many other examples I had also given, like CEO, COO, CFO, CMO, general manager. All these are at the top level of the management. Then middle level, all the departmental manager, purchase manager, production manager, finance manager, production manager, plant superintendent. Then the lower level management, which is also known as the operational manager management and the supervisory management. So the example of these are supervisors, superintendent, foreman, jo humne chapter 2 mein kiye the, functional foremanship mein foreman, section officer. So make sure that plant superintendent is at middle level, don't get confused. And if only superintendent is given, then it is at the lower level. And all the managers comes at the middle level, but the general manager is the manager who comes at the top level, because general manager is just after the board of directors in the companies. Top level per board of directors, CEO, CMO, chairperson, and then after the board of director, the post is general manager. So general manager is always considered at the top level. Next. Three levels, top level, middle level, I have already told you. Then the functions, in short, I am telling you all the functions. Top level management is basically doing all the important planning work. And that is the highest level, and it is having the most of the authorities. Top level is having most of the authorities. Maximum authorities are with the top level management. And they are responsible for the welfare and the survival of the organization. And they are, what are the functions? Framing policies, organizing function. Key appointments, all the CEO, CMO, general manager, all the important persons of the organization are appointed by the top management, doing the complete controlling. And most important, one more thing, they are also keeping a relation with the outside world. Whatever the changes, scanning, environment scanning they are doing on daily basis. Then the middle level, I told you about this level, that this is a link in between the top management and the supervisory management. So whatever the instructions top management is giving to the middle level is further passing those instructions to the lower level. Okay, students? Okay, Shita. So next is the consist of responsible implementing, and one more other thing they are doing, they are sending the feedback of the lower level, their performance report to the top level. They are also taking all the decisions regarding their own department. Like production manager is working at the middle management. So he is responsible for all the work under his department, as well as he is coordinating with the other department also. So interdepartmental coordination they are also setting up. Then the third is the lower level. Make sure whenever assignment of duties, link, communication, coordination, all these are the function of middle level. Supervisory level is the level which is directly related with the workers. So it is the level which is directly attached with the workers. They have to get the work done from the workers. They have to oversee when the workers are doing the task, and simultaneously they have to give them training also. So link between the middle management and the workforce, quality maintenance, guide to the workers, supervisors, ensures discipline, ensures training to the workers. If workers are not able to perform the task, then they provide training. Ensure safety measures to the workers so that no accidents are happened at the machine. Next, five functions of management. Planning. Management is a series of five functions, interrelated five functions. Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling. These are the five chapters which are left in the management book. First three chapters we have done. So functions we will be starting after cycle test. Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling are the five functions of the management which each and every manager has to perform. Now the last topic, I am not going to explain these functions because we will be explaining it in the chapter itself. When we will be doing these chapters, there in detail we will be explaining it. Then the coordination. Coordination is very important function of the management. It is not a separate function of the management. Rather, it is the function which is present in all the functions of management. So, I had given you 2-3 words while finding out the coordination answer in the case studies, like harmony, balancing, timing. So these are the three words: harmony, synchronization, balancing, and timing. If you find all these words in any of the case study, then the answer is coordination. Orderly arrangement of group efforts to maintain harmony among individual efforts towards the accomplishment of goal or the organization. Characteristics of coordination: integrates group efforts, ensures unity of action, continuous process, pervasive function, responsibility. Coordination is the responsibility of all the managers. It is not like key top level managers are doing coordination. Each and every manager has to coordinate with others. Pervasive, required everywhere. Continuous, you all know. Then ensure unity of action. All the employees in the organizations are working, doing work for them own, in their own way. And the whole of the work done by the different employees is coordinated to, directed towards a direction to bring the unity of action. Deliberate function. Coordination is a deliberate function. It means it is created deliberately. Deliberately means intentionally. It is not achieved automatically. And the last topic, importance of coordination. Why the coordination is important? Growth, functional differentiation, and specialization. So these are the three reasons. When the business grows in size, number of more people will be there, then it will be difficult to work alone. So in that case, coordination will be required, because as many of the people will be there in the organization,